What is up and welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Flippinstoop. I hope you guys are rocking this day out. I hope you're enjoying this day. Here in Michigan, we hit 71 degrees. The downside on that tomorrow, it's supposed to drop back down to jacket weather, right? So every single year in Michigan, if you're in Michigan and you're a reseller and you're watching on YouTube, you're watching on Facebook, and you do not know, every year, this time right now, this weekend, a little town called Freeland, Michigan, near us, has an annual, actually it's called a walleye festival. They have the walleye festival. And during that walleye festival, they have more garage sales than you can attend in one day. It is physically impossible to hit every garage sale in this little town in one day. There's no way. We were there for a good 6 hours today. We didn't touch a tenth of them. But so for any of you know, or that you like to travel and go out and source, you should mark this on your calendar, right? The last weekend of April, every single year, is the Freeland Walleye Festival. You could probably look it up on Facebook. You could probably Google it. It'd probably be in there. There's prizes for fishing and all that good stuff. But it is by far around us the biggest event for garage sales that I've ever come across. So we went today and we found some pretty interesting items. We wound up buying a lot of items. We only spent a couple hundred dollars, but within $16, I'm going to show you guys these items. In $16, about $800. So would make about $700 in profit, $758 in profit. So how you turn $16 into $700, at least $700 in this video, right? Remember last week, I believe it was last week or the beginning of this week, I was talking about table tennis paddles, right? I ended up finding a couple brand new in a house we cleaned out. I listed them for like $20. They're still sitting there. But remember I said, look, this is so crazy that, you know, the good Lord works in mysterious ways or whatever you believe in. I don't care if you believe in rock. I don't care what you believe. I don't care if you don't, if you're atheist, that don't matter neither. As long as you're positive and you're a good person, it don't matter what you believe in, right? So I said, look out for the vintage butterfly table tennis paddles. And unbeknownst, why we're here, I'm about to leave because I have a handful of clothing. And I'm not going to show you guys all the clothing. These are nickel and dime clothing I found. Maybe I did find a couple $50, $100 items. But I don't want to go through the bags right now. But I will show you the butterfly table tennis racket I found. It's vintage. It actually is the only one I found on eBay that still actually has the paddle case to it, I'm not even going to open it because they're selling without this, just the cardboard box and the paddle. I've seen them sell for $400 two times on eBay. The same paddle sold for $400, but it didn't have this, which it's actually got the person on it, that created the paddle, the gold medalist or whatever. But in the corner, this, I'm going to do some more research in this. This says competition. So I'm almost wondering if it's written, it's wrote on it. Somebody grabbed this and wrote competition on it. So I'm almost wondering if this was actually going to be used by this gentleman, whoever creates this, because obviously he's a world-class table, or was a world-class table tennis champion. I don't know if he's alive anymore. This is very vintage, possibly from the 70s, 60s, maybe before. I don't know exactly. I don't know all the research on it, right? I just looked up what they were selling for. The ones in the box that were saying new, I seen them sell from anywhere from $200 to $400. But like I said, it didn't have this on it. It didn't have this poster. And it did not say competition written by somebody. So I'm almost wondering if this was one of his personal paddles he was going to use in a game. It only makes sense to me. What it says competition in here. You know, I'm sure all the paddles that he used in his game said competition on it. I'm not sure, though. Maybe when you did buy them from the store or went to an event and bought them, maybe they did say competition. I don't know. But this is clearly That is hand wrote. That is not a print like this. It's not a print like the butterfly. So it is so crazy how we found this too. I wish I could have had the video camera on. We're checking out. And I just so happened, like, at the checkout table to glance behind me and see that yellow box. I had no clue what it was. I picked it up and I'm like, babe, does that say what I think it does? She's like, yeah, it says butterfly. I'm like, oh my God. I didn't even look it up. I didn't care. I seen the used paddles that look like somebody ran them through a grinder, sold for $60 and $100. So I didn't even care to look it up. I already knew it would be a profit. This was, where's the price tag on it? It must have came off. They must have took it off. $1. $1 for anywhere from $200 to $400. I'm listing this for at least $400. I do see some of them listed for $600. I don't think I'm going to list it that high, but I'll have to do some more research. I'll let you know on that, right? The second thing I found was just a pair. If I can get to them, right? It's just a pair of Sperry topsiders. We did pay upright for it. The price tag says 5 or 15, but we did pay 10. They have a fox fur trim on them. Where's that in the inside? I know. No, I'm sorry. It's fox fur, not fox. My fiance mistake that. But they're a very nice boot, brand new, for 10 bucks. I seen them for sale for about anywhere between $45 and $55. So for 10 bucks, I'm willing to do that. And it's got the box. Anytime a pair of boots or shoes has a box, the value is more. Okay, so I was excited as hell when we found this one. I didn't know the value of it. I'm going to tell you this. I have to write it down because I'm not a Star Wars fan. All right. My brother Josh was a huge Star Wars fan, right? He could name all the characters. He can name all the spaceships, all the little weird, crazy shit, right? You ask me, all I know is Star Wars, right? That is all I know. So I'm going to have to grab my pad of paper for this one. So what we found, you guys are going to laugh at me, you Star Wars fans. But when you see what I paid for it, and what it's selling for, you won't. The Star Wars Millennium Falcon. A monster model of it, right? A huge model. This was probably the second garage sale we went to. They had a $20 sticker price on it. I offered $15. They took it. I don't know if it works yet. I've not put batteries in it to see if it works. But I know it's, first of all, it's huge. Look at it next to me. This thing's a monster. So I thought this was a really rad find. Everything is here. I'm looking to try to find a spot that would unscrew to put batteries in. Or if anybody, let's put it this way. If anybody knows in the comments below where the batteries go, okay, it does got a gun. I think it is missing a couple guns. I can't find anywhere where the batteries would go. It takes batteries because it's got a big, huge light on the back here that lights up a purple. It's got little speakers right here for the noise. It is missing, I believe, a gun right here. I think something goes here. And I'm pretty sure something went here, like a satellite of some sort. And I cannot find that inside this thing. And I know it opens up. I had it opened up. I don't know where the batteries are going, but we paid $20 for this. Or no, they wanted $24. We paid $15 for it. And they're selling the only one I see listed right now that's the same as this one is listed for $387. I've seen them sell for $340, $350, $360. I think one sold for over $400. But once again, I can't find out where the heck the batteries go in this thing to put batteries in it and test it to see if it actually works. Because, of course, it's going to be worth more money if it actually works. But I thought that was a really rad find to show everybody in the group. Man, if you find something like this at a garage sale, I thought the price was outrageous. When I first seen it, I'm like, 20 bucks for an old toy? And then I thought about it. I said, that's Star Wars, right? So I looked it up. And it was definitely worth our buy, almost 400 bucks. For a $1,500 thing. So we had a really good day today. We had fun. I really hope everybody's getting out and getting garage sales. I can't tell if this is the hash brow one. Or if it's maybe older yet, I don't know. Don't know what all these things do in here. It's got a bunch of different things, and I can't find a sticker on it. The Hasbro one I seen that was a 2008 was listed for $387. I don't see any prints of anything on this to be able to tell me what brand it is. Looking it over and over, I don't see anything. Yeah, usually you got some printing or something on the bottom that would tell you. Anybody has any information on these? Like where the hell you put the batteries in? Where you find the make and model of it? Let me know, please, in the comments below. So, out of this one here, so this was $15 and that butterfly table tennis paddle was $1, so $16. You could say they both possibly could sell for 400. I'm doubting it. I'm doubting it at least on this one. I do believe that paddle could sell for $400 or more because a lot of them have sold. But some Star Wars fan most definitely will pay at least $300 for that big unit. I'm almost positive. Now that was three items we found. Like I said, we did find a bunch of clothes, but I don't, you know what? For some reason to me, going through clothes and showing clothes that I find, unless it's something super rare, super vintage, like so unique that it's just got a super cool vibe to it. Like, I'm not gonna show you a pair of Levi's 501 denim jeans. Like, I'm not gonna, like, I just feel like that's a waste of time. It's gonna bore people. And I just don't wanna do that. So I thought these were a cool find and I wanna share them with you. I hope everybody's getting out enjoying garage sales. And remember, the last weekend, we're gonna go again tomorrow. Maybe I can get some footage tomorrow of us actually picking and finding. I wish I could have with both of these items. Man, that would have made a cool video. This one actually, maybe I could have made some video content, but I was so excited to see all these garage sales. I didn't even think about it. My apologies, guys and girls. But this one, they were, I don't know. I try to read people. This is what, here's my thing. I don't know about other states, but I feel almost in their home that is disrespectful. I personally would not want somebody walking up my driveway with a video camera on. I would, matter of fact, probably tell them to leave. That's just my personal opinion. I don't think I'd want that, right? Now a flea market or something like that, whatever. It's public, it's whatever. And I do feel like other people around me, or at least where I do my garage sale, would feel the same way. Hey, we don't live in like Texas where everybody's happy, okay? Like everybody's not happy where I live. Okay, I'm just gonna be honest. Like I used to work at a store, a Skechers outlet in Birch Run. And we had ladies from Canada come down to the outlet because they could buy so many pairs of shoes for so cheap, right? So they love to come down. And they would comment, because they would stay here for a week, about how rude people were here in Michigan. They're like, "How do you live here?" I'm like, I was born a racer. I don't know. She's like, "Everybody's so rude." I'm like, you know, maybe we overlook it after we stay here for so long, but it's kind of truthful. Right? I'm not saying everybody in the state of Michigan is rude, okay? But like there is a different hospitality in different states. They're just some people are just more naturally friendly in different states. You know, they conversate with people they don't know. You don't go in Saginaw, Michigan, where I live, and just stop and talk to everybody on the corner. You don't do that shit. You don't know who you're talking to. You don't know what's going on. You better just mind your own business, right? In that neighborhood or whatever neighborhood you're in out there. So I'm not saying, listen, please don't misconstrue that. I'm not saying everybody in the state of Michigan is mean and ornery, but these people from Canada believe that for sure. Like they're always really chipper people. All the Canadians we had come in from, or from Canada, they're all super nice ladies, so talkative. Like they would just kill my time clock. Like they would come in, I'd help them out get shoes, so on and so forth, help them try them on. And like by the time they would leave, I was ready to punch out. I loved it when them ladies come; they were super rad. All right, it's your boy Flip. So tell me what you guys think about the Millennium Falcon. If you would have picked that up for $15, tell me what you think about this butterfly tennis Table tennis. I used to play ping pong too, right? Here in the here where I live, people call it ping pong, not table tennis. But I guess when you take it serious, it's table tennis, right? We played that in a short update on the computer, the G3, the vintage Apple iBook from 99. We've had people message. I had it marked at $500. We had two people buy it back to back, and then they canceled the order within an hour or two. So I upped the price. I'm like, look, I want somebody that's going to be serious. Plus, we have a 25% off coupon on our store right now. So if I have it listed for $700 right now, they're actually going to get it for $600. And I've had a couple interested buyers. One buyer sent a 550 offer. I counter offered with the 600. I probably should have took it. What do you guys think? If not, there's a lot of people seeking it, so I'm sure somebody else will send a 550 offer. It's your boy Flippinstoop. You guys have a rockin' rad day.